area of rectangles and triangles, a la Shmoop. Okay, Big Sis is coming home from college, and you've decided to welcome her back by covering every square inch of her bedroom with photographs of Zac Efron. But all the bedroom walls are different shapes and sizes. Thanks to the creative architect, there are even some triangles in there. So how do you figure out how much space you'll need to cover? Well, that's where area comes in. You might know that one wall is 10 feet long and 8 feet tall, but those are just one-dimensional measurements. Area tells us how much space there is on an entire surface. In this case, each wall, ceiling, and floor. Area is measured in square units, which could be square meters, square miles, or any other sort of square measurement that strikes your fancy. For your little photograph project, using square feet probably makes the most sense there. Okay, so the calculation for the area of a rectangle is very simple. You just multiply the length times the width. Donezo. If we want to find the area of this rectangular wall, which is 12 feet long and 8 feet high, all we do is multiply 12 times 8, which is 96 square feet. Now you can do the same with the other rectangular walls as well as the floor and ceiling. 10 times 8 feet is 80 square feet, 12 times 10 feet is 120 square feet, and so on. Well, to find the area of a right triangle, the formula is 1/2 the base times the height. So for these bizarro walls, we would take 1/2 times the measurement of the base of the wall, which is 6 feet, and multiply that by the height, which is 8 feet. 1/2 of 6 is 3, times 8 is 24 square feet. And what do you know, Zac even looks good at an angle. When all your individual measurements are done, you can add them together to find the total square footage you'll need to cover with photos. It was a lot of work, but boy, it was worth it to see the look on your sister's face. She has an odd way of showing her appreciation. Must be a college thing.